wait for the Lord shall renew their strength. They shall mount up with wings like eagles. They shall run and not grow weary. They shall walk but will not faint.
We are here to praise Almighty God, whose purposes are good, whose power sustains the world that he has made, who loves us, though we have failed in his service, who gave Jesus Christ for the life of the world, who by his Holy Spirit leads us in his way. As we give thanks for his great works, we remember those who have lived and died in his service and in the service of others. We pray for all who suffer through war and are in need. We ask for his help and blessing, that we may do his will and that the whole world may acknowledge him as Lord. I ask you now to be seated for a few moments. Can't see without my glasses. The title of the book that you have today is Pro Patria Mori. It comes from a poem that was written by a fellow by the name of Horace about 2,000 years ago. And the whole line actually goes, "It is sweet and proper to die for the fatherland." And the British poet Wilfred Owen borrowed the phrase when he wrote The Great War. And the phrase that has actually been used in lots of blockbuster movies that were way before the time that even your parents were alive. Movies like Johnny Guy's Gun, All Quiet on the Western Front, and the great blockbuster Gone with the Wind. And it's been used lots of times in various novels, music groups, Cassavian, Skyclap in the UK, and Camelot in the United States have used this phrase actually in their music. And it is the title of the books that you've been given today, as we said. And it's also inscribed on the wall of the Royal Military Academy, Sandhurst. The full title of the poem is, and if you've been studying non-Roman Catholic Latin, please excuse my pronunciation, Duce et decorum est pro patria mori. It is sweet and right to fight and die for your country. The Christian understanding of what 259 Felsteadians did when they died in battle is best summed up from this quote from the Christian part of the Bible known as the New Testament. And that is that greater love has no one than this, to lay down one's life for one's friends. In other words, that's what God thinks about those who give their lives to defend others. Every one of the Felsteadians you will hear about did exactly that. They did not run off and hide when they were called to defend the cause of freedom. Your school was founded in 1564, and that's about 400 years before my little Catholic high school in California was founded in 1952. Felsted has had a long history of excellence. Probably already know that. And out of that history comes the fact that in the Great War, of the 1,200 Felsteadians who died, the death rate was nearly double that of the rest of those who served in the war. But there was a good and noble reason for that. A high percentage of Felsteadians were young officers who were expected to be with their troops at the front line. In other words, they were leaders, good leaders, something that I pray that each of you strives every day in your lives to be. Each of you are blessed that you do not have to endure war. Your grandparents, and at least your great-grandparents, they were not so fortunate. They heard the bombs. They saw the destruction. You coming here and learning about the devastation that is caused by war, the lives shattered, the loves lost, I really hope it leaves you with a determination to do everything in your power as leaders, to be sure that we are never at war again. The future, my friends, is actually up to you. That's an awesome responsibility. As Felstedians, you are part of a great legacy of people willing to go way beyond just doing the basics. Listen now as we hear about some of those great heroes and celebrate them, those who have come from Felsted.